My name is Gina. I'm 58 years old, and I have lesions all over my body. They're on my face from here all the way down, and on this side, this is a primary area. If I hold my chin up, it looks like I have bat wings. I became aware of my condition when my daughter was born, and she's now 21. And they start as a small bump, and then I have blood clots that come out, and they're tremendously painful. I've had this one since 2013. It still itches. They never heal all the way, and they itch tremendously. My theory on the cause of the itch is whatever's underneath is trying to surface. I've got this cream to put on them, but some of it aggravates it. I have seen several dermatologists. I did try the medications prescribed. I don't think anything works, and the concern is not knowing what the real disease maybe is. Last dermatologist I saw walked in, and the first thing she said was, "You have OCD." And I don't have OCD. Yeah, I scratch them, but I only do that when it's bothering me tremendously. I don't just pick a place on my skin and start working on it. I don't know why somebody can't give me something and clear it up.
Oh, definitely, I agree with that 100%.
It's very frustrating to have physicians tell you that there's nothing medically going on in your body and what's going on is all in your head. I think they're wrong. That's why I need to go see Dr. Lee, because I respect her opinion. And I feel like she'll hear what I'm trying to express.
Most often, we as dermatologists can look at skin conditions and place them in two categories. That really helps us to narrow down that diagnosis and try to figure out what a patient has. The skin lesions that Gina is presenting with really doesn't fit into any category of any skin disease that I know of.
I have all this going on.
Okay.
Uh-huh, yes, I see.
But see, that's like a new one.
I'm hoping that a closer look to other areas of our body will help to get a bigger picture of what's going on here.
So I can see that you have these scars and they're up here. There's nothing really in the middle of your back, but then they come on around back down here. You can reach back here, right, to this area here.
Yeah.
Gina's scars are very unusual. They're really erratic. It's not psoriasis, it's not eczema. This is when I really have to use dermatological detective work.
It's probably not some kind of internal skin issue because they have this sort of erratic edges and scarred, like, you know, like kind of like jagged edges.
Right.
That is something that doesn't typically occur organically in nature. You know, if you get something that's coming from internally, they're usually more rounded. It doesn't have jagged edges. That's
right.
More of a what we call a factitial. A person is creating that kind of shape. So that's something we pay attention to as dermatologists. On your back, we can see where you've had these lesions.
Right.
We can see that they're in areas that you can reach. So you can reach here, you can reach down here, but you can't really get to the middle of the back. So that's sometimes a clue to us.
Okay.
But I did also look at your chart and I noticed that you had biopsies. It says the skin is thickened. When you see thickened skin, it's usually from repeated just rubbing or scratching the area.
Right.
And there's lichenification and excoriated. Excoriated just means it's scratched, obviously.
Right.
But lichenified, too, means that there's a chronic kind of pattern of rubbing or scratching the area. So that's what they're seeing under the microscope. And they did a stain to see if there was fungus there. They obviously checked to see if there's cancer or anything there. So
right.
That's the good news.
Oh, absolutely.
The good news is you don't see any of those.
Right.
You know?
You're trained as dermatologists to be able to tell the difference between a real skin disease and maybe a self-inflicted skin disease. The microscope doesn't lie. It can be hard for people to take that first step and sort of admit to themselves that, okay, maybe this is something that I am doing to myself.
You're trying not to pick at these, that's gonna be our window to making them all better.
So, just to be sure.
Yes.
There's just no reason that it itches.
There's a vicious cycle of when something's triggered and you rub it and you scratch at it, you want to scratch it again. I feel like you're really probably very frustrated about this.
more than frustrated.
By what I'm telling you, or?
Just because I disagree.
Gina has lesions and scars that are due to chronic picking of the areas, but she disagrees with this diagnosis. In cases like this, it can be difficult to convince a patient that this is truly not a skin disease.
Do I pick them when they itch or when it hurts or whatever? Absolutely.
But there's something there to pick it up, is what you're saying. Yes,
exactly.
Yes, right. I know you just want like a magic wand, like I can give you a pill, but it's in your power to do this.
Oh, wow.
You have to be the one that takes control of this, and you can do it.
So when they start itching, what should I do?
Maybe an ice pack in there would start to help to block it, putting a bandage there, a dollop of antibiotic ointment. But it's very hard. I understand, and I know you're a smart, strong woman. Mm-hmm. I think you're going to be able to do it.
Thank you.
I do.
It's just a lot to take in. It just puts the burden back on me. Okay.
It's not an easy fix for Gina, but I'm gonna try to help her in any way I can.
All right, I have something. Have you ever seen this before?
I don't think so.
Hydrocolloid dressings, and it helps to let it heal faster, and it helps to keep your hands off of it. And put them there and leave them on for like even a week.
Okay.
We can do it.
Okay.
These medicated bandages that I prescribed for Gina should help break the cycle of her picking at her skin if she uses them consistently.
It's been several weeks since I last saw Dr. Lee, and not a lot has changed. I still have the lesions, and I still itch. I tried Dr. Lee's bandages for 2 weeks. Keeping them covered helps. But if you go out and you're out for the entire day, the first thing I want to do when I get home is take them off. I do disagree with Dr. Lee and her theory that I'm picking. That's not me. Totally not me.
Ma, stop scratching.
Well, I'm not scratching. I'm just seeing what it's doing.
I'm over here talking about it on a daily basis. I feel like if my mom doesn't listen to the doctors, it's going to just not go anywhere in life. It's just going to be the same thing over and over.
I intend to see as many physicians as I need to see to find a cure.